teachers and the fellow trainees. I am extremely sorry for the delay, but here I have something for you all. We have been talking about the speech in Chicago which Swami Vivekananda had given, and we owe him so much respect. So here it is, a clip of the speech.
Swami Vivekananda.
I see as imperative for each one of us. Not are Indian. Yes, that's one of the reasons. But the other way, that we are going to be teachers. We are going to mold the nation. So I, Santa Gupta, will be presenting a PowerPoint presentation on Swami Vivekananda and the truth. Before we dive into that, it is imperative that we know a little bit about him. Though he is an ocean of knowledge, but one talk where I am very sure will make us an intellectual like none other. Name, Narendra Das Datta. Date of birth, 12 January 1863. Place of birth, Calcutta. Bengal Presidency, now Calcutta in West Bengal. Parent, Vishwanath Datta, a distinguished and a successful lawyer. Who is Ishwari Devi? His mother, who was a very pious lady, and prayer of Lord was a way of life for her. Education, Calcutta Metropolitan School, Presidency College, and then the Scottish Church College, Calcutta. Institution, Ramakrishna Math, Ramakrishna Mission, Vedanta Society of New York, and his death was on 4 July 1902. Place of death was Bedorma, West Bengal. That is his mother, and that is the place, that is his home, which has been turned into a museum after his death. Now, what are the various factors that makes Swami Vivekananda who he was? First, equality of mankind. Swamiji firmly believed in equality of mankind. He did not believe in biasness, in caste system, and various other atrocities which were given and which were put on the society and in his existing time. Regarded as India's foremost nation builders, this is one fact which cannot be denied. He was one of the most important leaders when it came to forming India in various aspects, philosophy, education, character, and so on. Gandhiji and Jawaharlal Nehru were influenced by his teachings of service or to the fellow men. He finds education as the manifestation of perfection that is already in man. This line has been spoken a lot of times since yesterday. So what is manifestation? Manifestation comes from the word manifest, which means obvious. Manifestation, which means display. In Hindi, production. The manifestation of perfection that already is in man. Now, three events, which are very less, but I thought it are three events which I are important. The Brahma Samaj, which was led by Keshav Chandra Sen. He included himself in Brahma Samaj in 1880. Then comes his meeting with Ramakrishna of Dakshineshwar, which happened in November 1881. Now, when he met Ramakrishna, he was in the quest of knowledge. There is this one question he asked every time to each one he met. Have you seen God? They gave answers unsatisfactory. He wasn't happy. He asked the same question to Ramakrishna. And very firmly and confidently he said, yes, I have seen God. I see God as near as I see you, but in a more intense, inner manner. This invoked respect in the mind of Swami Vivekananda for Ramakrishna. But Swami Vivekananda, being who he was, tested his guru a number of times. And Ramakrishna, with love, with respect, treated Swami Vivekananda. And then, as we all know, Swami Vivekananda became the disciple of Ramakrishna. The next is Parliament of Religions at Chicago. The very famous, we all know about it. We heard about it a few minutes ago. It was Parliament of Religions at Chicago. His friends at Chennai collectively made him. It was not, he didn't get the invitation first to go, but his friends offered him that he should go. He must go there, visit, because he had something in him which his friends felt that he is the best person to represent Hinduism in the world. So that is where we went to Chicago, and we all know what happened. The rest is history. That is Keshav Chandra Sen, the founder of Brahma Samaj, his guru, and a clip from the Parliament of Chicago. Now, education. We all talked about education. What is education? Real education is that enables us, one, to stand on one's own leg. Education must provide life building, man making, character making, assimilation of ideas. Such powerful words, such meaningful words put together. Now, what are the aims of education? Why should we educate? What? Just so that we can speak in English? No. Creation of self-confidence. What is self-confidence? Self-realization. Formation of character. Service of mind. Promotion of universal brotherhood and searching of unity and diversity. Now here are the three C's I was talking about. Character, concentration, contemplation. What is character? We all have distinct characters. We all are different from each other. What is concentration? Can anyone tell me what is concentration? We watch a YouTube video for 4 minutes. That is concentration. That is concentration? Or we get up in the morning and say, no, today I have to do yoga, I have to do meditation for 2 minutes and I will have concentration. What about the 23 hours, 58 minutes of the rest of the day? What are you doing then? Are you concentrating? No. You aren't? What are you doing? You're doing whatever you feel like. That is not concentration. I would like to quote Meenakshi ma'am like she said yesterday. Working for 6 hours and doing social service for 1 hour will not make it social service.